What we're looking at is a masterpiece that is at the end of its era. Audi is discontinuing the Audi R8, and in front of me here is my 2008 Audi R8, which I want to give you my 3-year ownership review and update of this car. If you guys have been following the channel, 3 years with this car from the original pickup in Montreal, this was my dream car. I fell in love with this car when it was first introduced in 2008. It came on the scene in the Iron Man movie and I was blown away. And the first thing that you want to think about or you start talking about when you look at this car is the exterior styling. It is absolutely beautiful. It is what actually had Audi create a whole new design principle for their entire lineup of cars. This R8 was the introduction of those design principles with the beautiful LED headlights. This was new to Audi. It was actually one of the first cars ever made with these LED headlights in this system. And it honestly transformed the entire look of the lineup for the Audi cars. When I saw this, it was a timeless design. It was absolutely breathtaking. To this day, it's still as timeless and breathtaking as anybody's ever seen it. I go to a gas station, I go wherever, people talk about this car, they actually think it's a 2022 or a 2021. Absolutely not, this is a 2008, but this is a car that I bucket in and I describe as one of those timeless cars. I think Honda S2000, I think NSX, I think Audi R8. I think these are the classic cars that don't ever look like they're aging at all. And I think the Audi R8 has just such great proportions, this side blade style that they introduced here. It's really what made it unique and classic. And I think after 3 years of ownership, by the way, you know, I remember opening the garage and always just coming to look at this car. And I still do that to this day. That honeymoon phase just doesn't go away. And I think a lot of that is attributed to the fact that it's so timeless. It really does still look beautiful. And I just get so excited looking at it and driving it every single day. I think a lot of it goes to that timeless, beautiful design. Let's talk about the specs. This is a 2008 model. This is the V8. This is the 4.2 liter V8 engine making 420 horsepower, 317 pound-feet of torque. Revs to an RPM of 8,200 RPM. So this engine likes to wind out and it's also reliable. This engine was in the Audi RS4 as well from this generation. So it's a tried and true engine in this mid-engine configuration. Then made it to that, you have a 6-speed gated manual transmission. I'm gonna be talking about that in a moment. Actually, I'm not gonna do any talking. I want you to listen. Honestly adds such an element of the experience of this car that I'm gonna be obviously talking to you a lot about. This is what I've loved about this car, is rolling through those gears, feeling like it's a bolt action rifle. It's been amazing. Now, what sounds just as good as that 6-speed manual transmission? It's our latest sponsor, Canada Drives, and their 100% online car buying and to-your-door delivery platform. They offer the most convenient way to buy a car in Canada, where you can shop, finance, purchase, and even trade in your current vehicle completely online. Every car comes with a 7-day love it or return it guarantee, a rigorous 150-point safety inspection, a free Carfax vehicle history report, warranty, meticulously detailed car with a full tank of gas to get you on the road and into your next driving journey. So make sure you check out Canada Drives. I will link them in the description box down below. The great thing about this car, and that's why I actually called it the best everyday driver supercar, it's got so much luggage space as well. So while this is a supercar, and you can take this out to the track, and I just went over to the track as well, so if you haven't seen those track videos, I will link them in the card above, and also make sure you subscribe to see more videos of this car. But you see, there's a lot of luggage space in here. You can go ahead and still put a whole bunch of stuff here, groceries, everything else, in this car. And this is just one area where you can go ahead and put some luggages as well. So it's not only a great track weapon, but if you come over here as well, you'll also see, if you're a fan of golf, you can actually stick your golf bags just back here. There's a lot of space here with some netting as well. It really is just makes it easy to take the car around and not just have it just for track use, but also so you can live everyday life and do what you need to do with the car. And in the 3 years of ownership, I've done my groceries with it, I've taken it to the track, I've taken it to the drag strip, I bring it to show and shines, I do everything I can. And the exterior of the car is just, it's just beautiful, and the usability of the car, it's really up there as well. I did put a paint protection film on the entire front end of the car. It was really important to me that I protect the finish. I was a professional detailer for the last 10 years, so I was really, you know, wanting to make sure that I kept it pristine. This is a 2008 model. The first year it was introduced with the manual transmission, I did that entire full PPF. So especially if I'm going to the track, I don't need to worry about stone chips or rock chips or anything like that causing any problems. Now, the interior of the car, I'm gonna go ahead and take you in there and describe a little bit about the interior. It has aged a little bit, but it's honestly everything that you would ever need from a driver's car. So we're in the car, and yes, it has aged from 2008, but a lot of the materials are of high quality. You have full leather everywhere, leather up to the dash. Obviously, one of the big highlights in this car is the 6-speed gated manual transmission, and if you can hear that, it just sounds phenomenal. It sounds like you're rowing through or loading up a bolt action rifle and going to war. It's really a great experience. Steering wheel, flat bottom steering wheel here. Now the MMI units, the navigation units, all very obviously old. I have a magnetic phone holder here that I attach my phone to. And then I also have a Bluetooth auxiliary adapter. So that way I can get all of my kind of functionality here anyway, and I have my music via Bluetooth. So none of this is really an issue at all in terms of the inside. I still think the inside of this car is beautiful. I think it's handsome. I think it's driver focused. It has everything that you need. Heated seats, you know, traction control, all your controls are here. Everything about the interior of this car, I think, is good for the people that are looking for a driver's experience. If you're looking for a bunch of luxury features, this isn't the car for you. The highlight of this car inside is this beautiful gated transmission that's sitting here as the crown jewel for the interior of this car. Now, a big question many people have when you're potentially looking to go ahead and buy this car is maintenance and reliability. It was one of the things that obviously I looked at extremely diligently when I purchased this car. So in terms of general maintenance, you know, oil changes, those have been done with Bill from Garage Auto Sports. These are common maintenance items that you have to do. Brakes and rotors, consumables, tires, consumables, all of these normal things that you have to do, air filters, you have to do with any car, you do with this car, that's fine. Now, some of the unique things that you have to think about or you have to look at when you're actually looking to purchase this car, number one is the magnetic ride suspension. On these cars, all of them, for the entire generation model years, they all prematurely fail. So you're gonna have a problem with that. Even if you go ahead and look at one, it may not be, you know, failing right now, it may not be leaking, it will leak in the future. So you should think about what type of aftermarket or other OEM solution you may get. In this case here, I went with the BC Racing coilovers. I was really happy with them for the street. It's really great, and I just took it to the track and it performed admirably. I probably will adjust it to actually be a little bit harder. So that's one piece. The second piece is the air conditioning compressor. Again, they all fail for these generation one cars. There's a whole slew of different reasons as to why, but the thing that you should be aware of is on the V8 model specifically, it is technically an engine out repair, which can be costly. So you need to make sure, see if there's been any receipts around what has happened. Have they replaced the AC compressor in the lifetime of the car? With the V10 model, thankfully it's not an engine out repair. And I will note with the V8 model, there is a kind of shortcut method where you don't have to pull out the engine to replace the AC. Knock on wood, since I've owned the car, it did have the compressor replaced earlier in its life, and I haven't had any issue with the air conditioning unit. So it's been rock solid on that front. But when that time comes that I know it's gonna happen, where I will have to replace it, I will be taking the shortcut method to go ahead and fix this with Bill from Garage Auto Sports. So that's a little bit about the maintenance. In terms of other things that I've done with the car, I did add the custom ADV1 wheels. If you haven't seen that video, I'll also link it up in the card above. These are in this beautiful shadow silver 4-stage powder coating process that matches the side blade. Looks absolutely stunning. And I also did get a full custom exhaust from Bill from Garage Auto Sports with a stage 2 tune as well. It just sounds amazing. I love the way this car sounds now. If there's one thing that I think in my ownership period, I kind of wish I jumped on a little bit earlier, was an exhaust. I wanted to make sure I keep everything stock, and I did, but I wanted to go ahead and get something that, you know, makes the car sound like how it looks, which is aggressive. I always joke around, I think this car is kind of like the Beauty and the Beast in a way. And now I have a Valvetronic system where I can go ahead and turn it on and when I want to awaken the beast, and then turn it off when I just want to keep it nice and pretty and roaming around the city streets. So those have been the only real kind of maintenance items that I've done on the car. You should be aware, yes, it's going to be a little bit more expensive than your, you know, my Lexus or a Toyota or something, of course. And when repairs do come, it is gonna be more expensive. When the clutch comes on this car, it's probably gonna be, you know, an expensive purchase. I've heard quotes from $4,000, $6,000 because it's an engine out repair. So these are things that you have to be, you know, cognizant of, that they're gonna happen over the lifetime of the car. I expect this clutch is gonna last me up to 70,000 kilometers, and I have about 54,000 kilometers on the car today. These are all things you should be thinking about, but generally I'll say, in 3 years of ownership, I've been extremely happy with the car. It's been extremely reliable, and everything that I would expect has been staying true and staying up to form, like the engine and transmission have been. And the things that have failed early, like the magnetic ride suspension, has. So those are kind of the top line things you need to be aware about in terms of, you know, maintenance and upkeep of this car. So now let's talk prices. You're probably interested in this car at this point. If you haven't, and if you're not, you should be. It's honestly one of the best cars I've ever driven, and I've had the privilege to drive a whole bunch of supercars. The prices for these things have gone up. How much they've been touched on by COVID, and we see the used car prices for all car makes and models go up. You know what, I did see these start appreciating before COVID even happened at about 5% a year in terms of appreciation. Now these cars have appreciated significantly more. So compared to about a year or a year and a half ago, you're looking at about 10 to 15% more in terms of the price for these cars. But there's a lot of good reasons as to why. Number one, obviously, the Audi R8's discontinued. They're no longer gonna be making this car. It's such a shame. What an amazing car. Audi's first halo supercar. They couldn't have done a better job in my opinion. So there's a lot of historical nostalgia that accompanies this car, especially the gated transmission cars, the six-speed manuals, which are obviously discontinued now. And those values for these cars are at least 10% higher than the R-tronic or the S-tronic versions. And with the rise of electric cars, I think that shift is happening in the market a lot faster. Thus, these cars are gonna continue to hold their value for a lot of the nostalgia in the older engines, the internal combustion engines for these cars. And this is an engine a lot of people love. It's the 4.2 liter naturally aspirated V8, 8,200 RPM redline. All of these things, I think, make it to be an epic experience when you're driving this car. And that's why I think the values have held up really well and they're actually appreciating and going up. That's the one thing, obviously, like when I went onto the track, I wasn't the fastest car out there. Absolutely not. Lots of cars, even, you know, the mid-size sedan cars have more horsepower than this car today. But the fact is that this car does such a great job in bringing so many different elements together to create an amazing driving experience. The engine, just the sound of the engine behind you. And then with this custom exhaust, you get kind of all that auditory impulses that you love and that you want to experience in a supercar. Then knowing that you have full control on the car, the six-speed manual transmission shifts and sounds like nothing I've ever driven. It's honestly a unique experience. You definitely feel as connected to the car as you possibly can. The riding position's also very good. You're definitely down low compared to other traditional cars. You have a great visibility across the windscreen. You see everything and you feel everything. The car is well planted. Obviously the magnetic ride suspension's gone, but with the BC Racing coilovers, I definitely feel planted at the track and on the street. And all these pieces aid to the experience that you get as a driver and as an owner of this car. And then every time I come and look at it, I can't believe this is a 2008 car. And I know I've kept it in good condition, obviously, because I'm an OCD detailer, but look at this thing. This thing is so beautiful. It's one of these timeless cars that will never age. It just looks like it's brand new from the factory. It looks like it came out of the future, and this came out 15 years ago almost. And that's the one thing I love about this car. You know, my heart is still in it. Even after 3 years, I go back to the garage and I look at it all the time. Because I just look at it, I say, oh my God. Like, this is the most beautiful car I've seen. And, you know, I'm trying not to be biased. There's lots of other beautiful cars, but there's no beautiful car that caught my eye like this caught my eye when I was in high school, when I was a kid, and I was looking to get this car one day, and I couldn't be happier. I don't think I'll ever sell it unless, you know, knock on wood, financially something happens. I don't ever plan on selling this car. It just means so much to me. And the fact that I still get that enjoyment and that, you know, that love and excitement every time I see it, it's just, I just can't get rid of it. And you don't see much of these cars out in the market. Actually, in Canada, I'm pretty sure last time I checked about a week ago, there was only 3 cars in all of Canada that were on sale, which is crazy. So you have owners that love it. They're keeping the car, a lot of nostalgia, a lot of history from Audi on this car as well. And I think that's gonna keep prices going up and up.
And thus, if you have any questions, please leave them down in the comment box down below. That was my 3-year ownership update of my 2008 Audi R8. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. If you did, give it a like. Make sure you subscribe, over 29,000 subscribers for any type of car content, motorcycle, detailing. I cover all of motorsports basically on this channel. So make sure you subscribe and I'll catch you guys in the next video.